This was the scene on the steps of City Hall where different youth organizations from all over San Francisco came together to send a message of solidarity. These young people say they will not put up with Islamophobia, transphobia, anti-immigrant policies, nor cuts to education. They blame the rise of these problems on President Donald Trump. Philam District 6 Youth Commissioner Mary Clara Mable led the rally and says that many Filipinos are affected by these issues.
There has been talk of a lot of cutbacks from fundings of education, and a lot of Filipino youth in the city attend public schools, and that's a really big issue for us. You know, there have been multiple attacks on immigrant communities, and we're one of those communities.
I said, what do we do?
Student Maverick Ruiz says that the threat of losing education funds from the federal government because San Francisco is a sanctuary city is a slap in the face of the youth.
Public education for us is so big because if they take away that, it's basically one of the biggest options that we have to succeed in life. And without it, pretty much it's just taking our right to even progress in life, to even become successful.
I'm talking you and me, give you the truth and speak it through.
These Filipino youth say it is important that the youth play more of an active role during these times in order to achieve change.
No more time for excuses, they'll be humbly trite.
Definitely what the Youth Commission is doing is we're trying to empower the youth of San Francisco, you know, to speak out for themselves, to lead themselves, because essentially, you know, like the youth of this city, we are the future, you know, and that's what is important.
Following the rally, the Youth Commission voted on a resolution in opposition to federal attacks on immigrant, Muslim, and transgender communities.
Yeah.
Ramel Kinclair, ABS-CBN News, San Francisco.